Welcome to this video. In this video, I would like to show and explain to you how you can analyze logs for specific tables and customize objects in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. Enjoy this video and let's get started. So to analyze customizing objects or tables, first of all, you have to open up the transaction code SCU3 in the command field. Then you will end up in here and then you have to click on the button Analyze Logs. Then this selection screen will open up and in here you can type in the ID of your customizing object or table, and in this case I have typed in the table T000. It's a table that stores information about SAP clients in the SAP system. Under analysis period, there you can distinguish whether based on this customizing object or table some changes have been made. Under evaluation 4, you have to specify whether this ID is reflecting to a customizing object or table, and under output options there you can select between ALV grid control, only actual changes, and the pen table changes, what you like to. And if you want to, you can also evaluate the archived logs. And how can you check whether this is a customizing object or a table? So in this case, it's basically both, because if we open up the ABAP dictionary and type in T000 and then click on display, then under delivery and maintenance, there you will see that for the T000, there a C delivery class has been entered, so it's a customizing table and not just a table, so for example like a application table is. So, and then I will select ALV grid control because I prefer it, and I recommend to use ALV grid control because there you will get a nice list of all the changes, and then you can execute this. And then in this case here, we're directly seeing what kind of changes have been made. So for example, today's the 21st of December. This SAP user on that time has made changes in this transaction code, in this program, what kind of change he or she has made. So in this case, I have created a new entry, a new client in this table. And here we can see that I have made some changes, not a creation. I have added or changed the city. So here we can see that I changed the city from Waldorf to Munich. So this is the old entry and this is the new entry. If you want to, you can also deselect ALV grid control and let it display like this. There you will also see that a data record has been created, and here we can see that I changed the city field from the old value Waldorf to Munich. So this is really nice. And compared to another table, so for example the hrus underscore D2 table, it's a table that stores information about substitutions. And if I would, for example, select customizing objects, then you will see what happens. Then I can't execute the selection because it's not a customizing object, it's a table. So I have to select tables. And then you will see, for example, and if I would just like to show the today's changes, so I select the 21st of December and then execute the selection, then we see that we now can analyze the changes, and here we see that this entry has been created. And for example, if we're going one step back and then typing in a table, so for example this table, and then execute it, then we can see that for this table logging is not turned on. So you can click on yes, but you won't see any changes in here. And how can you in general analyze logs? Because as we are seeing right here, that not for every table the logging is turned on. So to analyze this and for you to activate it in further development or creations of tables, we have to open up the ABAP dictionary once again in the transaction code SE11. And then we type in this table, so for example, and then click on display, and under technical settings, or also executable with the key combination control shift and F9, here this is the checkbox that allows you to create logs and to analyze logs in the SCU3 transaction code. So in here we're seeing that this checkbox is not checked, is not selected, and because of that no logs will be created based on any changes being made in on this database table. And for example, if we're going a couple of steps back once more and then type in the hras_d2 table, and then again on the technical settings there we see that this checkbox is selected, and because of that any changes being made on this table are logged. And keep in mind, it is really important that one specific profile parameter has to be turned on in the whole SAP system, because if that's not the case, then logging in general is not possible. And because of that, we're opening up the RSET11 transaction code, and here you have to use REC/client, and for this I click on display. And here it is important that this value is set to all. And basically, what are the possibilities or values you can set? So basically, as we're seeing here in the kernel, default value off. Off means that the logging is in general turned off. And if it is set to all, then it means that in the whole SAP system, logging is turned on in all clients. Or if you want to, you can also specify one specific SAP client, and in just this SAP client, logging is turned on. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions left to logging an SAP system, let me know in the comment sections. Hit the subscribe button to not miss any further important and useful videos. And then see you in the next video.